Hi everyone, I'm Maya, and today I want to share with you how to make this beautiful crochet swimsuit one piece. I named this one Mermaid Dream. This piece is my third one from this design, and I want to share with you a little bit about the material. The first one I had used 97% cotton and 3% elastic. And I have to say, when I went to the water, it was not like I thought it would be, because I think the cotton is too high. With just 3% of elastic, plus I used a bigger hook for that, the first one, because I was trying and I'm not sure which hook would be better for the yarn, because the package of the yarn, it said that I can use 3.5 to 4 mm and I just playing around. So it was sagging in the water and it didn't hold the shape at all. After a few hours of research, I mean few hours, maybe like 7-8 hours, I found out that cotton is good for summer and it's great material for, you know, if you're not going in the water. But as soon as you're going to the water, it's going to sag, because this is the nature of cotton. So I found out that either you use acrylic or polyester. But acrylic is so hot. I mean, in the summer, it's kind of not so comfortable. And I don't like personally acrylic, I mean, either polyester. But polyester has proven to be the strongest material for swimwear. And I found this company in Thailand and the owner, she's super sweet. And we talk, I didn't ask her though what material would be good. I would just, trust my intuition. And I just ordered from her this cotton. This is a cotton mixed with polyester. And I was just surprised to see how it held the shape so well. I went to the water, I swim, I went to the river, to the waterfall, and it's just perfect. I come out of the water, it takes about a few hours to dry. It's not that quick, but the shape is not different at all. It's just perfect. So you don't have to order from this company, but if you want to, it would be great to support her as well, because she have also a different kind of material, organic cotton yarn, which she start this journey or this company by her own, and she also support other women in the community. You can just look more about that, and it's also your choice to use the yarn from your country, because I think if you order from her to America or to Europe, it would take about 3 to 4 weeks to arrive. So it's all up to you. It's just a suggestion. It's not, I don't get paid to tell you about this yarn at all. I just want to share with you my opinion. So let's get started. I hope you can hear me better, because some of you have mentioned about my voice is not that clear and it's too low. So I got this microphone just for you. All right, I'm going to make the swimsuit size XS, and I will link in the description box what size for how many chain. So before you start, you can have a quick look. And let's start it. So in this project, we will use about almost, this one is 100 gram. So we'll use about 180 gram for the swimsuit, and maybe more for bigger size. I'm going to make size XS, so it's about 180 gram or less. And I use crochet hook number 3 mm, yarn needle, and a scissor. I put this aside. Let me start. For the size XS, we're going to make in a fine comfortable position, like I'm sitting on the floor actually. We're going to make 13 chain. Can make a slip stitch, but I like to count this one as one, but you can make just slip stitch and do 13 chain. And you got 13 chain, then you do two more, and then you will do half double crochet in the third chain from hook, and one is along. And count. Yeah. And then the last one, I already got my 13 half double crochet into the last stitch. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put one more and then chain one. And then I put two more in the same. And then I'll do one half double crochet on the other side, down the row. I think I got 13 this side too. I want to count. Yeah. So I would encourage you to count your stitch. You come up here, one each. When you arrive here, 13, you do one more, 14, you chain one. And I like to just count one side and don't count all as one, if you understand what I mean. So I have 14, chain one, and then I count one, two, in one stitch, right? And then 3, 4, 5, 6, I count another side, 14. So the first row is like 14, 14. And then I will do chain two. I turn my work. And I will do one half double crochet each, in each stitch. And also I count along. So my last one here, 14, and then in here, in the chain space, I put two more, and then chain one, and then the same chain space, I also put another two. So here like 14, and I got 14, 15, 16, right? 14, I put two more. 16, and then I chain one and I put two. I start to count 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh no, when this thing happened like this. Okay, one more thing of this yarn, this especially brand, is have often this knot, which I don't like to crochet over it, so I'm just gonna cut because I like it to be neat. So how many already? Okay, tomorrow will be 16, so I have to attach. This is how I attach the yarn. So 14. No, 15, 16. So this is just the way I count the stitch. I just count one side at a time, but yeah, like I said, you do what you feel like. Then you chain two and then you turn. You're going to repeat this second row like so. You do one half double crochet along. When you arrive to the chain space here, you put two half double crochet, chain one, and then you start this side, two half double crochet inside, and then one half double crochet along. So in each row, you will increase to this side and to this side. So in each row, you will increase together four stitch. For the size XS, for the XS size, you will make, we were going to make 10 rows, and again check in the description box how many rows you need to make, and I will meet you when you got that rows done. So now you got something like this. I have managed 10 rows for this XS size. Then you return your work to the bottom part, and we will make chain two, and right in here, just right in this space, we do just in the bottom here. The idea is we're going to put one half double crochet in each row. Yeah, let me show you again. So here is the row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This part we have 10, and this side we have also 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And here is the middle part, right? So we're going to put half double crochet in each of these row, the bottom. Chain two, then just like so, then the next two, three, four, five, six, seven. Eight, nine, and 10. So we arrive in halfway. It's the last one. 10. So when we start this one, the other side, I count 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So actually, yeah, 10 also, but I forgot to mention the chain two we count as one. So basically the first row we have two half double crochet because the chain two count as one half double crochet, which means the last one we're going to put one more. You can put one more right where is the last one you have done, or I like to go in here in this stitch, the chain stitch here, kind of. I like to call this stitch as the border stitch, so I just go in the chain stitch. A little bit hard but possible. Then I make one more half double crochet. So yeah, one each, only the first two and the last two. And now we're going to chain five. And we turn our work. Still we work in the bottom part. Then we skip these two chain stitch and we make now double crochet. The next. And chain two, we skip also another two. Then we do double crochet. The next. Chain two. Skip two, two, and now what we're gonna do? We have three left. I like to make, instead of two chain, I make one more chain, three. So I skip three and I go this one here. This is the end. This is how I do. So I have all together 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 boxes. Let's see how our work looks like so far. And this is the cup. Like so. Start to forming the cup. And for the first one, when you're done, you just chain one and cut the yarn about here. And then just leave it there, and then you will make another one. So I already had made the first one. But the second one, when you make the second one, this is the first one, right? The second one, you will leave the yarn like that because we're going to connect it together. Okay, so make sure, because one side, the end, you have three chain. Maybe it doesn't make any difference, but I like to do that. This one that I cut the chain will be on the bottom. And this, the second one, also this that have three chain will be the bottom. Actually, it doesn't matter, but I just like to do that way. And then I will continue here to connect that. So now we're gonna connect it together. This one that put this one away a little bit. This one that has the yarn still connect. This is my second day of filming, so just catching up with what I left yesterday. So from here. Here you do five chain, and then we will double crochet in here. But I would like to call or name it as a border stitch, so it's kind of like in the end. And then we will be doing one double crochet in each stitch here. Mm-hmm. And then we will stop at one stitch before the last one. So this is like the, you can see the two stitch that to have the double crochet that we put inside the chain space. So we're gonna put into one of those and we stop there. And the camera. So here, just stop one before the last one. Yeah, and then you chain five. And to connect, take the other cup. And we will also find the stitch of the one before the last one. We should this one. This is the last, and this one we got to prepare. Double crochet in each stitch. You will do this along here, one double crochet along until you arrive the last one here. And here's my last one. When I got to here, I chain two and I will do half double, I will do the double crochet in here. You see the last chain from previous row, just on here on the top of this one. Do like so. This is last one. So let's create the same this box here and here as well. Now the second row, we're going to chain five. Turn our work, and then we will put double crochet here in the end. The last stitch, just here, the border stitch. And from here, chain one, we skip one, and we double crochet in the next. I have to look, yeah, my old one. That's what I remember. All right, and then we skip one, double crochet in the next, chain one, skip one, double crochet in the next. So this is what you're going to repeat, chain one, skip one, and double crochet in the next stitch until the end, until the last stitch here. I show you, you do this along, and then the last one, it will be this one, and then here we will do two chain. I will show you when I arrive here. I'm here, the last one. Then I chain two. And I will put the double crochet in the third stitch. You can count the stitch from here, 1, 2, 3, or you can count from here as well, because it's going to be the same one, like 1, 2, 3. Then here what we have, the second row of this one. And now this next row we do something different. Okay, we chain 3, we turn our work, and then we will skip these 2, this one and this one. Okay, let's count like this. Now I will call this a column. So we will skip this one column, the first column, and then we'll come to the second one. Second column, we're going to make a shell stitch. So in this pattern, the shell stitch will go 3 double crochet, then chain 2, and then 3 double crochet in the same space that we have put 3 double crochet earlier. So here 3 double crochet, 3 double crochet, chain 2, 3 double crochet. And now we will skip this column and then we go to the next. You put 1 double crochet in there. Yeah, and now we're going to repeat. We skip this and we go to the next one. Skip this one and we go to top of this one with shell stitch. 1, 2, 3, and then chain 2. Has look like. And then we do the same, we skip this one and put 1. Oops. Crochet. Wow, the first time using this microphone and the anchor of my phone is trying to do my best. I hope you can see. So basically you repeat this shell stitch, you skip 1 column, 1 double crochet, then you put the shell stitch here, then you skip 1 and you put 1 double crochet here. Yeah, just this pattern along the way until the end. I will meet you around here and I show you how to do the last one. So my last shell stitch in here. Then I will skip this one and I will simply just put 1 double crochet from the third chain space for the third chain stitch. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. And this is how it turns out. So pretty already. Yeah. And now we're going to the next row. We're going to chain 6. work. Then from here we're going to put one single crochet on the top of this chain space and chain three. Then we put one double crochet on this one. You see, on top of this. Yeah. Can you see? Single crochet and then double crochet just right in the line here. And now we're going to repeat it. Chain three, put one single crochet top of chain stitch, chain three, one double crochet, and keep repeat this until the end. So right here, the last one, chain three. And I will put my last double crochet just, let me see, just right here, the chain space. See, not this one, but this one. This little one here. Go in there. Now we will chain four for the next row. We turn our work. Then from here, you just, let me think, the easy way is, yeah, I'm just gonna put one double crochet just right in the chain space. Yeah. Chain one. Then I put here on top, just right here, the single crochet from the previous row. Put one double crochet to create this. And chain one. And then put one inside the chain space. Chain one. Then just put one on top of this one as well. Chain one, put one inside the chain space. Chain one, put one on top of the single crochet. Chain one, put one inside the chain space. Chain one, put one on top of double crochet in the previous row. Chain one. Chain one. Actually pretty much of this. Let me show you how it's done. We are repeating this kind. Yeah, so I will explain to you later how the pattern goes, because we're going to repeat it again and again. So I arrive here, the last one. I already chain one, then I will find also the third stitch. Here, I put one last double crochet in there. And this is, let me explain to you, this is pretty much of the pattern, because we're going to repeat it. The pattern of this one actually have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's actually have five rows. The first row is double crochet along. Now we have this connection, so we have this five stitch. But normally from now on you're going to make this row with double crochet from here along here till the end. And then the second one will be this this design, which is the same with this one. Wonderful Crochet, chain one, Wonderful Crochet. And then the third is the shell stitch. And then the fourth is this one. You see the one under here that connect this line. And then the fifth is again Wonderful Crochet, chain one. So this is one set from here to here. One, two, three, four, five. Five rows is like one set. And I'm going to repeat one more time this set, and I will tell you how many sets you need to make for XS. And yeah, for different size, and how can you calculate that for different sizes. I will also put it on the description box so you can see anytime. All right, so we're gonna repeat that to start the next one. You're going to chain three to begin with. And turn our work. Then we just put double crochet and chain space. Then double crochet on top of double crochet from previous row, and then one chain space. See, chain three, double crochet, one double crochet, just along. One on top of one double crochet from previous row, one inside the chain space, one on top, one inside. Continue until the end. I meet you there. When you arrive here, the last double crochet on top of this double crochet from the previous row. Not forget to put one inside here. And one more also, because there's just one chain space and one more here. Just have to find here, yeah, just this one, the third. Let me see, the third chain from here, or from, yeah, just count from here, it's easier this time. One, two, and three. Then put one there as well. This is your last one. And this is the next set, the first row of the next set. Now we're going to turn to the top one. I'm gonna do this one now. I'm gonna chain four. Turn our work. We are repeating. We are repeating this. You see? We are repeating this second row. Because this is our new set, the second set, the first row and second row. So you're going to do the same like this. You can go back to see how we did the second row. Because you're going to repeat the second row, the third row, the fourth row, the fifth row. And yeah, I'm going to make, I will count, this is one set, no? But it's easier if you count the shell stitch. This is one set. And you remember that the end of the set is will finish with this row, with this design. So five row. I will going to make for this side, I'm going to make five sets, which means in the end, I will have five shell stitch I will cut here, and then I make sure in the end of my set is this design. So I meet you in the end of 5 sets. And when you come to the last set, let's say, because as I mentioned earlier, I make size XS. So here, this one until here we count as one set, no? I repeat again. 5 row, like 1, 2, 3, 4, this one, and 5. This one is called one set. So to be easier to count, I just count the shell stitch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Instead of have my this one as the end, you see, because every set finishes with this design. Only the last one, it doesn't matter how many sets you made, you gonna stop like me on the 4th row here. Do not put this one, I already did and I just round it out again. So you just, after the shell stitch, you make one row in this design, in this pattern, and then you stop there. And we're gonna continue from there. I will show you how. So from here, we chain 2, turn our work. Then we put 3 half double crochet in this chain space. And then 1 half double crochet on top of the single crochet in previous row. Three half double crochet in chain space. One half double crochet on top of this double crochet in previous row. And then 3 half double crochet in chain space. And keep repeat that. 3 half double crochet in chain space, 1 half double crochet on the single crochet, 3 half double crochet, 1 half double crochet here, all along. And also count this time how many stitches you have. I will meet you in the end of the row. So I have the last, I arrive here in the last chain space. One, two, three. When I got 3 in this last chain space, I also need to put 1 more as the border stitch. Just have to have 1 more. So not to forget, do not forget. You can put the last one on the 3rd chain of turning chain. So here, I got total of 72 stitches. This is right after your belly button, because I make, I also will include everything how to measure from the under breast down to this part for to see how many sets you need to make. To measure it down here, this one measured down for the body of 7 inches from under breast to the belly button. And when you measure this, you have to stand up, not sit down, not while you are sitting down. So from here, I'm going to decrease. There's many ways to decrease your work, what I like to do, I just change one instead of two. I put the hook in, and then one more time, and I pull to three. This is how I decrease. Then I count as one. Then I put one half double crochet along and just keep doing like this until the last two stitches. You will also put them together as one. So I got to the last before the two last, actually. So I got 69 stitches, and then I'll put these two together. So now all together I have 70. So I'm going to repeat this decreasing of, yeah, now I have 70. I'm going to do all together 10 decreases rows. So here I got 10 rows of this decreasing part. So now I got 52 stitches together in the last row. What we're going to do, we're going to count 8 stitches and put the stitch mark. So here, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here, when we got 8 stitches, then we just put our stitch marker here. And then this side as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And yeah, and then here between we got 36 stitches. What we're going to do, we're going to slip knot and start our decreasing from here again. I have to cut this one first. Let me finish this. So here, gonna slip stitch. For the beginning, I normally just do like that. I show you again. Put the hook into the stitch that we start. And then I just go here, so count as one. And then continue with half double crochet. Two, three, four, five, six, just along one half double crochet along, and then the last two you put it together. So here I got my 33 stitch, and then the last one, 34, I put these two together, got 34 stitch. Now I chain one, turn my work. I will do the same. I'm going to make a decrease stitch. one and then half double crochet along. And I will repeat this for another, like now it's my second row. So I'm going to make all together, since I do the stitch marker here to side. So I call this one row, the second row, I'm in the second row now. I'm going to make a total 12 rows from now. So not to confuse, here is 10 rows. And then we do decrease. We start over again from here. Hope you can see. And we count here one again. And now the second one here that I start from the stitch marker to side. So I decrease. The first row was 34 stitches. At 12 stitches, and this is the last row of decreasing. Now what we're going to do, we're going to make this 12 stitches, no more decreasing. This is going to be a middle part, so we're going to make 12 stitches of 1/2 double crochet. And then you're going to put 1/2 double crochet in each stitch along. Don't forget the last one, 12. So you have 12 half double crochet. This is the first row. Going to make together of 12 rows again from here. So here I got 12 rows of 12 half double crochet stitch here. You can already see it start to making a form. It's the middle part of this one. Show you. You would have something like this by now. And now we're going to increase. This is the back part. I show you how to increase. It's very easy. To increase, we then put 2 chains. Now I already have 2 chains ready to continue the next round. So I turn the work to increase. First half double crochet in the first one, and then we put one more in the same stitch, so we have 2 half double crochet. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then the last one, we put 2 inside as well. 13, 14. So this is our first increase stitch. So I'm going to move our stitch mark. How you call stitch marker, however you would like to call it. And I'm gonna place it here
to know that we have our first one. And you're going to make the increasing rows in total of 30 rows. So now we have one. And you chain 2, 10, and you put 2 in the first, 2 half double crochet in the first stitch, and 1 half double crochet along here's the finishes of 30 rows. So it's expand to the side. This is how increasing of the back part turns out. If you follow everything, you make the same side or different side, you could probably have already something like this, I hope. So we are almost done for the bottom part. We're going to put 2 rows up here, gonna put this design here, this pattern, and the shell stitch. We chain 4, turn, we skip the first stitch. We don't do anything in the first one, and we put the hook into the second one, make a double crochet. We chain 1, we skip the next, go into the one next to it, chain 1, skip 1, go to the next. And remember, now it's not half double crochet anymore, this is double crochet. Skip 1 and 1 double crochet, chain 1, skip 1, like this. Almost there. Here, one double crochet, skip 1, 1 double crochet, chain 1, skip 1, go to the next. So this is it. The next row, the last one, finally chain 3, turn. I think I skipped, let me see my one. Okay, to begin with, we're going to skip these 2 columns, these 2, and we're going to, going to put the shell stitch in the 3rd column. We put 3 double crochet. Chain 2 and 3 double crochet. Then we skip the next column, this one, going to put 1 double crochet into the this one next to it. And now you do the same. Skip the next column and then shell stitch into the next. Exactly the same with the pattern on the body part. Same tune. You do this, skip this, and go to put a chain stitch here, skip this, put one double crochet here. Just repeat this across until you finish here. Got here, so my last chain stitch is here, and then I'm going to put one double crochet. You see, here is one double crochet from previous row. Going to skip this and then go into the second one. You see, this is the stitch from double crochet. This one is skip stitch and we're going to put in the second one. Yay, we are done. And from here, we're going to put, this is going to be strap to tie. So going to chain 100. 100 is enough. After you chain this part, then you're going to connect here. Just let's do on the second as well. So it's going to pull from here. I suggest you not to go in the hoop, in the loop, in the chain space. If you want, you can do it, but it's better to go in the chain. It's just my way. So yeah. And after you make the chain both sides, then we're done for here. Then we go up to do the cup part, to finish the cup part. So I have done this side, the chain strap. I just continue from there directly. And the other side, I'm going to connect from this one, the second one from the shell. Here. Remember, you can do any way that you like it. And do this way. This way. And then you count 2, 3. So I got 100. And here. Ta-da! You wrap it in later, the yarn. It's done. I really love this pattern, this design. Okay, let's continue the bra cup. Here's the bra cup. We want to make the box design in this part as well. Coming down here to connect the other side. I'm going to find the third stitch, the third chain. Okay, we count. So 1, 2, 3, then the hook there. I'm gonna attach. Don't forget to leave a little bit like this so that you can weave it in later. And you attach that. Don't count this one as one yet. I experienced it's become too short, so I count here one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're going to do here, one double crochet. It's better to have a little bit more space. My one was a little bit short. Let me see. Yeah, great. And from here, we just do like the bottom part, chain one. We skip just one. And then we one double crochet to the next. Chain one, skip one, chain one, skip one. Ah, I forgot to skip. Just have to find the right anchor for my hand. Chain one, skip one. Let me check. Chain one, skip one, and skip this one and go to the next. This was the last, this is the last one. So we have two chain between the top and the bottom part. All right, just two stitch that between the top and the bottom part, the under breast part. So from here, let's chain one, two, three, and then go right to the middle part, middle stitch, right to the middle of this double crochet that connect. You see, show you the middle part as a shell stitch. You're going to put here, just right in the middle here, a double crochet after we chain three. Then chain one, and again one more, and chain three. Then we're gonna find here two. The other side have two stitch between, so we do the same. We go to the third and chain one, skip one. So it's here the middle part, right? Now going to do the same in the other side, like the other side. Into chain one, skip one, one double crochet to the next. So now I arrive here, going to put one more here before I put another one as the border part. So I want you to know that when you do this part, you have to count, for example, this part, this side, not counting the first box, just counting from the cup. I have 16 boxes. And now when I put one more box, it's gonna be 16 the same. It had to be the same. And then you do, okay. I put one here first. And then the last one for the border part, then you chain two instead of one. Then you find the third stitch from the turning chain. Then you do one more here. And that's it. Then you're done in this part. So both sides, including the border, will be 17 boxes of both parts. Now we're going to do the chain for the strap to tie around the neck. Now we're done. I put 100 for both straps. This is almost done, let's say. Now we have to put the chain, also the strap on the front for tying the side together. The row number 5, I'm gonna put the strap there because this one is for the customer, so I'm not gonna put it on to try. But yeah, if you make it for yourself, just put it on and try where you want to put the strap. And that's it. Wave the yarn in and send me some photo of you wearing it. If you post a photo on Instagram, just tag me as well, MayaLunaCorazon. And if you use Facebook, you can join our group called Crochet Conscious Growing Together. Or follow me on my page, facebook.com/MayaLunaCorazon. And if you use my pattern, please give me the credit of where you learn from or where you buy the pattern from. This way we're growing together, and also I know that you appreciate my work. So here is the final view of this one piece mermaid swimsuit. I actually add one more strap here. The original one was just here, and I add one more just the end of this pattern. I add another strap both sides, so the front we have two and the back we have one. And I will turn, show you the back. This is how the back part. I only do a cross two times, like one cross, but it's like one here and one here. You can do one more time to go at the end here. See, put it on and see how you feel. If you need one more, then you can do. I end up made 550 chain for the strap at the back. And that's it, we are done. I hope you like the tutorial, and stay with me for more video to come. Thank you so much. Have a beautiful day. Bye.
Hi everyone. I want to make a quick video just for you to see the update with this swimsuit. In the written pattern and also in the video, I just made back in the back side two string and one at the front. And then I just changed my mind. I like two at the front and two at the back. Better, it look better and it gives more support as well. You can also wear this way separately, like so, or you can put them together like this. But of course, you can do in the way that you prefer. But yeah. I like it this way. And today I just wear it as a bodysuit because yeah, you can definitely wear for everyday life and kind of live in different right now. Well, and then can't wait to see where it is as well. I will be making more swimsuit, two-piece. Yeah, thank you so much for your support. I love you. Mwah.